everyone. Welcome to D's ASMR. Donna here. I had a request to do a tracing video. So I pulled out some paper and some tools that I can use as tracing tools. And I'll trace some of the Canadian money that I had in my wallet as well. And I'll use a variety of these tools. I'll show you each tool as I use them, and I'll explain what they are, but I'll start with my favorite one. So I'm an avid Harry Potter fan, so this is Harry's wand. I purchased this at Universal Studio when I visited a few years ago, and it works really great, not only for pretending to perform spells, but to trace. One of the favorite things I used to do when my girlfriends and I, when we were younger, would have sleepovers. When we went to bed at night, in our pajamas, we would draw on each other's back. And we'd always try to guess the letters or the numbers or the pictures that the other person drew. It was one of my favorite things to do. I found it so relaxing. And either myself or my friend would fall off to sleep first. But if my friend fell off to sleep first before I did, I was always so sad. Because it meant I didn't get any more. I love the feeling of someone taking your finger and just drawing it lightly on my back, on my shoulder, on my face, on my hair, anywhere. I wasn't big. So I will do a few words in cursive writing and see if you can figure them out if you'd like to. I'll do it again. Cat. Yes, as you, if you've watched my channel, you know I'm a cat lover. Do another one. I'll repeat that one again because it had more letters, so it was probably a bit harder. Staying in line with my cat theme, which was my first word, and my Harry Potter theme, you may have figured out that that second word was Dobby, capital D-O-B-B-Y. That's the name of one of my cats. And I'll do the other cat as well. Letters. I'll do it one more time. Hedwig. So clearly my cats got their names from Harry Potter characters. Harry's owl. Hedwig. And Dobby the house elf. Both who were amazing characters in that series, in my opinion. Now, this is not the only wand I actually have. One of my students gave me another one, and this one is very, very light. It's very light wood. It has a tag. It says it's 10.5-inch troll whisper whiskers apple wood. Rope, maybe? I'm not sure if it's rope. It's extremely light. It has a very unique sound. I'll trace some numbers on this page with this. I'll do it one more time. Going into my theme here tonight, Harry Potter, platform 9 3/4. I'll do another number, a very easy one. 7, yeah. 7 Horcruxes, although we all know, if you know the story, there was one more that was not intended, or another number important from that book. 3. The Deathly Hallows. 4. The Cloak of Invisibility. 2 years ago, our money transitioned to being a more plastic, synthetic, durable material. There's some parts on it that are completely see-through. I think it's quite beautiful. Comforting, really good. And it springs back where our older paper money that we used to have, it would get creases and it would eventually rip in two. Show you a few bookmarks that I also chose to use in this video. So this one was a gift from a student. I'm a math teacher. And this one says, "Math is a drama queen. It seriously can't have that many problems." So I get the humor. Works as a great bookmark, but also as a great tracing. I went pretty fast. I'll do that one again a bit slower. I'll try doing it in printing instead of cursive writing. See if you can figure it out that way. I realize I am a geek, and I accept that. I love me some Harry Potter, and I love me some math. Algebra is my favorite strand of math. I brought another bookmark as well. Very similar, with the dangling piece. This one has a treble clef, and again, this was another gift from a student. I don't teach music, per se, however I used to, but I do dabble in the music arts. I play trumpet, and I also play percussion for some local groups, and I help out in pit orchestras. I play trumpet, actually, in a few different local bands and ensembles, and sometimes I'm hired out to do small choir accompaniments at a local church. So I grew up playing piano, but piano wasn't really my thing. I didn't really have a very good stretch to reach an octave on a piano. My hands weren't large enough. Trumpet is much more my style, where there's only three valves to have to play. And then you can do some other things with your pinky fingers and adjusting, but it's a lot easier to manage. And you don't need quite as many fingers or quite as much of a stretch. And I just help out on percussion because so many of my friends who play, when we need help in a pit orchestra, there are always a multitude of percussion and auxiliary percussion and drumming parts that need to be covered. So they don't usually need more than just a few trumpets to help out, but they need lots of hands. So I've really enjoyed learning how to play xylophone and the bells and a variety of other percussion instruments to help out. So that's where this music one came from. There are two of my metal bookmarks, gifts from students, and they're fabulous. And you can never underestimate the value of a good old mechanical pencil. Simple. Sorry. In Canada, we have $10 bills, $20 bills, $50 bills. We also have $5 bills that are blue, but I didn't have any on me, and $100 bills that are brown. And then we have quite a few coins for $2, $1. I've done another video on my channel if you